Is a relatively large wave, but it's not huge. Onar also does not have red buff. He skipped it to make this happen. The Q sails wide, but the slow will come in. Nuggery is still hanging around, just chipping away here, but looks like the damage should be enough. Onar is taking a lot, though, and the Q finally comes in.
Yeah.
To be honest.
LCK teams don't like him because he doesn't team fight as well.
Okay, this is very aggressive, but it should be enough. Showmaker not even going to flash on a Doran's Ring. Still taking very aggressive trades. Here's Kellen, extremely caught out. That's not the magical journey you were looking for. Easy kill. Guma just going to scoop that one up. They're running and the amount of setup, especially the Kalista. Faker's actually going to have to hop out of here. Definitely a very strange, heroic exit as... Now Showmaker's in behind them. The Tempered Faith comes in, and the Justice Punch is going to hit Showmaker. The Immediate Grab comes in, and Duckdom is dead again with Flash. Not sure what it is about Ezreal's in this week dying with their Flash up, but now that might just be even more. Canyon is being run down here. It's looking likely. They hand it over to Guma, and this is going to be Kellen as well, as T1 are now just rolling them here in this game. Play against T1 kind of leaning back in our chairs because we don't want the fight. This time certainly taking the fight to T1, but that's maybe not a good idea either, as Nuggery has landed all of these needles as Ken, or Zeus is going to do a fantastic job dodging a lot, and actually Onar will be safe for a while, but now here comes Showmaker going to pick up Zeus as Faker is not going to kill Nuggery. Actually tries to escape.
Turn jumps over the Tempered Fate and gets onto the back line. And that can happen. In this case, it's all allowed to happen because Nuggery is immune, first of all. Then the needlework comes through, and he jumps over here. Really nice defensive ult from Zeus. Tempered Fate is locked in. Zeus like, do I come back in or not? And it's just too late. Showmaker gets on top of him.
Both teams were setting up for the fight. Domlin just played it better this time around. Just breaking down the front door. Okay, this time the Tempered Fate is there.
We could definitely trap some of these rotating Dom 1 players.
Yeah, Destiny does come in, though. They're trying to get on top of Karia here, but again, Showmaker extremely deep to try to pick that off, and now that's the Destiny down. It is going to group up Dom 1 and deny the flank as a big depth charge does come in as Duck Dom is just out of the fight. It's a big True Shot barrage as the damage now coming out here from Dom 1, but it's not quite enough. They're going to take down Gwen as well. T1 now 5v3. A lot of low health
Duck Dom on the Ezreal to be able to clean up those health bars if they do enough, but in this case it just wasn't. And they kind of baited this one in themselves. The Nautilus ult onto Duck Dom is pretty massive because it actually slows him down, but the True Shot damage is still real. Mm-hmm. And he gets knocked up a second time as well. Just not able to do enough here. The Gwen focused down. It was so close. Like there was, I mean, that fight was really on a knife's edge. But T1 now
dive from T1. He doesn't do well just firing Mystic Shots into tanks. As here we go, another big play on the top side. They're trying to lock down Faker, but a lot of T1 are here. Another teleport going to be used as they try to isolate Karia again, but he is quick on the play. And
Duck
look at
Dom,
this!
Man.
Duck Dom is alone again. Huge Tempered Fate at least is going to come in, and Duck Dom does survive. Actually is able to turn it around as Faker, the only one there on the front side. Guma was not here. That means that Domlin will actually pick up a kill.
Online for Guma.
Okay, here we go. Play as Showmaker goes all the way in. No cleanse here for Guma. There's nowhere for him to go as he is going to be taken down. And the Tempered Fate here again, but actually stopwatch is what's going to save DuckDuck's life. He finally does go down, but the heavy lifting again is Nuggery. The needles come through, and he pushes them into that huge front line of T1.
Teleport coming in, though, this is very greedy. If T1 really want to secure this now, I think you're just going to have to back off, and they do think better of it. But what's so beautiful about this play for Damwon Kia is these stragglers.
Okay, I mean, it is Canyon with the shields, though, so it's kind of difficult to force this T1. Owner is still going in, as now you've got Nuggery behind you. There is a Cloud Rift as well, but at the end of the day...
All right, there's still... I mean, they have a lot of damage. It's Kalista early, but there's not a whole lot of damage on this team otherwise, and that's true shot.
But yeah, the damage isn't quite there, it feels like, for T1, and there's not really a way for them to get out of here as the Paranoia comes down. Kurya's down, but he's trying to sacrifice. They get the Baron, and T1 are just trying to get out of here. The back promoter will not happen, but he can just hop the wall. Faker and Kurya will be the ones that sacrifice for it, as we do have Destiny.
Ellen wants to chase here. He has Tempered Fate.
Actually, I mean, they're playing with fire. Showmaker's not even that healthy, but...
Okay, this is greedy.
Where's the Faker? Oh, there he is, as Nuggery, he is in a lot of trouble. 2v1, he should be able to trade onto Faker, though the Sonyas will be used. He's bought some time, but it's only time that he's bought, not his life. He gets taken down.
Owner in the jungle there. They could have actually made a cross-map play. But they're just totally blind, and Nuggery is trying to be greedy because he's like, we can't defend Aryan, or I have to trade for something, but he can't. Okay, Tempered Fate's out.
Oh, they're trying to get Gume here once again. He does have Cleanse this time, but he's just going to survive, actually. The damage's not quite there. Nuggery was not here. The Flash comes in from Showmaker. They will take down the Kalista, as now the chase is on. It's not a very easy chase, though. DuckDom might be able to pick up Zeus here as he is going to hookshot over the wall and Flash to get away from this one. DuckDom... Again, still on the chase. Did you mention the Zonyas that DuckDom has picked up?
No, I did not. I have not. We haven't talked about that yet. We saw his stopwatch earlier. We didn't discuss it, but it's very strong, obviously, in this case, and very common to build as well, obviously, for an Ezreal into the Galio Camille Compass. Yeah, we don't really need to watch this again, but he gets punished. But again, this is very difficult for Damwon Kia to do anything about because there's no vision on their side of the jungle to stop those rotations in or try to slow and force a 4v3 fight on their side. Tempered Fate here is really good, and it's really difficult to kill the Kalista with this collapse with the Nocturne, but they pull it off this time. Really nice flash forward as well.
We got a fight right now. There's a huge taunt. Faker gets four of them, but the Tempered Fate is huge again as the heroic entrance does come in, provides that tankiness, but Kalista is down. Might not matter, though. The damage here from DuckDom, he's still pumping it out. Owner and Zeus can't quite get deep enough. They're trying to take down Ducky, and they will be able to eventually, as Kellen also on the run. No more magical journeys for him.
Entirety of some of these fights, then, yeah, this would look very
look
different.
Look at this taunt again.
It's massive. And Faker knows they don't see him.
It's five.
They know he is completely unseen. He knows he's completely unseen because there's a control ward there. Then he ults back on top of his team to give them an additional amount of shielding. And DuckDom, yeah, he can do a lot of damage, but he's an Ezreal here. There's just too much. There's too much tankiness, too much engage. I mean, it's a Camille and a Lee Sin on top of you.
Yeah.
You can't last forever.
They're like healing. 1v2 versus an Ezreal.
So, I mean, this is the five man. He has control ward. He's on the other side, so there's just no way they could see him. They walked right into it. This is the second flash taunt play in this best of three from Faker that's game defining.
Yeah.
And. Yep. You have to fight for this, though.
Tempered Fate. Destiny coming on over. They're buying some time, the Paranoia as well, but there's the smite, and there is the engage from Kurya again. And Nuggery, he can't even survive to draw out any needles. He can't do any damage because he just gets 100 to zeroed as the turn. Extremely clean here from the side of T1. It's now Owner is getting into that back line. Zeus is going to absolutely nuke DuckDom. He does not exist anymore. And that might just be the game at the end of this one. With the Baron, T1 should push to end.
T1 in control of this game from start to finish. One small error on top side, but beyond that, they just played a clean game of League of Legends. Canyon looks to be the last to fall here. Maybe
and
if he escapes, who cares? Bye-bye.
And Camille gets it.
Stolen.
Yep. Either way, a very clean 2-0 from T1. Absolutely a lot to see here, though. Both of these games were very entertaining.
And T1...
But Showmaker's also played so much TF, and I wonder, you know, at what point does he give it away and, you know, make his team play a different style, or how long will they stay attached to it?
It's a really good question. I mean, we haven't seen this Azir, which is incredible because he's a very strong mid laner, and that's the meta pick that everyone has picked up. Faker has played it. Obviously, the best player on Azir so far we've seen has been Chovy, but you know, you have to be able to adapt and play those meta picks, and this is just the comms, of course, here for T1, where Faker said it's done, it's over.
Yeah, they're pretty much just like, go, like, because we kind of went in right as Karia engaged, and wasn't too much else to say, right? It's a pile-on comp. You attack the targets that are in front of you.
I mentioned this earlier, and I want to clarify. I want to make sure people understand what I mean fully. Yes, Galio was played by Xiaohu, but the way T1 played around Vision, especially with Karia's Pyke in game one, where they go to objectives that are game-winning for them, the Souls, the Baron.